Today we're in a garage in Northern California and we're gonna hang out with Marc, who has a 1959 Volkswagen Beetle that I think is super, super cool. What's up, dude?
How you doing, Nicole?
Good. I'm really excited to be here because this is gorgeous. You bought this in high school.
Yeah, back in the late 80s, I was kind of getting into VWs, just, you know, between watching Herbie movies and my parents having an old 66 Bug that I used to jump in the back of when I was a kid. And, you know, the VWs were real popular in LA in the 80s. And then I found this one for, I don't know, $1,200, and it was all original. It had the original 1200 cc 36 horse engine,
and wow,
it's taken a lot of time and a lot of money and a lot of, you know, blood and sweat, and
right,
but I think it's there. I mean, I'm an engineer, so I wanted to over engineer it, and
right,
so I started with a single turbo and kind of not a real primitive fuel injection, and just kept going from there and there, and, you know, kept improving it and upgrading it, and, you know, until I got to this, which is now twin turbo, 2.4 liter and water meth injected, and it's got an independent, you know, water jacket for the turbos, uh-huh, and dry sump and suspension and brakes, and I mean anything and everything I could think of
to
get it to where it is, because I wanted it to be reliable. I wanted it to look good, mm-hmm, you know, go to shows. I wanted to be able to drag it, take it to the track, do track right days, and I just wanted to be able to do everything and then be able to drive it for right hours and cruise and comfortably.
Did this come with a ragtop or when you bought this?
No, originally it was a hard top, and I always wanted a ragtop, so I found another roof section and grafted it in.
Wow. So that's pretty ambitious to hack it up.
Yeah.
It looks awesome. What are those? They're like little fins back there,
yeah,
but that's just your engineer brain thinking at night,
yeah,
what I can do different.
And I can just, I can just pop them off. They're magnetic.
But they're so perfectly spaced that's also, you probably made a template, didn't you?
Yeah.
Did you?
It's easy to take them off, but it takes a while to put them off.
I'm looking at it going, they are perfectly aligned. And if they are on there with a magnet, you're OCDing about where, yeah, you're putting these for sure.
Yeah, you make a tape line and measure. Uh-huh. And so what these do is they create two little counter-rotating, uh-huh, vortices.
And is it pushed down or this causes it to not lift up?
It breaks up that turbulence so the air doesn't want to come up.
What is going on here?
Okay, those are called semaphores.
What's the word?
Semaphore.
Semaphore-like. Semaphore.
Yeah, they were also known as trafficators.
Trafficators. Now you've lost me even more. Yeah. Semaphore, trafficator, whatever.
So I'll show you what they do.
What?
And they were the original turn signals.
You're kidding me. Is this something that was original in 59?
In Europe, on the European models, they were original in 59, yeah.
That's like the super trick thing that they put in the side mirrors now, but even more,
yeah,
space age.
Yeah, they are cool, although
I've literally never seen that before.
Although you can't really go over 60 miles an hour.
Do they want to like fly off?
Yeah, I mean, this thing was designed to go over 60, and this little lens has flown off on me before, and it's hanging by a wire.
I have literally never seen this. So this would have been not in the U.S.?
Right.
Okay.
In the U.S., they had the little bullet turn signals,
yeah,
on the fender.
Up in the front.
Right,
yeah,
here.
Yeah. That's actually super cool. Did you actually have to do anything to get it to work again, or was it working when you bought it?
I had them grafted in. They grafted this section in.
And
then the semaphores themselves are original. So these are 6 volt, but then the bulbs are 12 volt.
You're getting how many horsepower out of this now?
About 230 at the wheels.
That's pretty good when you consider it's a light vehicle. Have you had it weighed? Do you know what you're
at? Yeah, I weighed it, and it's heavier than stock. Mm-hmm. It's, you know, 2,300 pounds.
Okay.
There's chassis stiffeners and roll bar, and there's, mm-hmm, there's a lot of added weight on,
sure,
it.
Sure. You have anything different underneath your front bonnet here, or just your fuel cell and your... Okay.
The original fuel tank.
Right.
Which, and I added a fuel sender, because originally it didn't have a fuel gauge.
Okay.
It had a a reserve tap that you would have to manually turn.
Didn't know how much gas was in it.
Right.
And you could...
You wouldn't know. Yeah, you'd run out of gas, and then you'd have to flip a lever under the dash to go to the reserve tank.
That's probably a smart move.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very cool. Then I also, I added a vent here. Okay. I sealed the cap because that originally vented here just to not smell gas as much.
Yeah.
The spare tires...
I love the leather belt. Man, that's so cool. You've just done so much to it, and yet it's not veered away from stock so much that it's just obvious. You just have to kind of look at everything, and mostly it's clean. You've done a lot to make this thing shine. You've taken it to shows?
Mm-hmm.
And have you won awards for it? It looks great.
First, second, third, best engine multiple times, so I was happy with that.
Yeah, it's, you just kind of have to like take your time and really look at it. It's really pretty. And this color, what color did you say it was?
It's mouse gray, which was an original color in the 50s, original VW color. And
so good.
I found color chips, and I mean, there's probably 10 different grays, and I like gray.
it's a pretty color.
It's my favorite color. So, you know, it was like, I went back and forth between a few different shades of gray, and then picked on this. So
it's subtle and it's warm. It's not a cool tone of gray. It's really pretty.
Hop in.
Wow. Oh my goodness. I just feel like there's like a lot to take in. It's gorgeous. You have 1,000 gauges.
Yeah, I'm a little gauge happy. You know, I worked on ships, and I used to just stand watch and stare at a wall of gauges for for 4 hours at a time. And so I like gauges. I like knowing what everything is doing.
You need all that feedback.
Yeah.
Because your brain is processing.
Yeah. And I think it looks cool, too. And I tried to integrate that many gauges without, you know, looking overboard.
Well, it looks like an airplane in here. But, you know, you fit it all in. You had to do the research and how to fit all of those in perfectly and clean. And I can't find a flaw with this car. I mean, you're very meticulous. I can tell. I'm not like a judge at SEMA by any means, but it just, to like a layman, this looks perfect and stunning. Who did all of your interior work? Did you tackle it yourself, or did you have all this hired out?
So the interior was made by West Coast Classic Restoration. They're in Southern Cal, and they're kind of like the premier VW restoration interior guys. So they made the seat covers, the panels, the rag top, and I installed it all.
Okay. You have a skateboard wheel on your throttle. What's going on here?
So the really old, the really early Beetles actually had a roller pedal like that.
What would be the purpose? It feels
because you can, when you push down on your
it
just rolls on your foot. And so later they went to a regular pedal, but it still had basically a little roller behind it. And
it's got to feel really weird though.
See. It's not that bad.
This is the dead giveaway. This is the thing that's the dead giveaway that this is gonna scoot, is the radar detector.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that.
So what
that
happens
helps.
If you get pulled over? Does a cop go, uh-huh? Does he look at that and go, uh-huh? You kind of knew.
I don't know, because I did get a speeding ticket a month or two ago, and.
So I love the white piping on your seats. It just ties into these like. These ivory, you know, knobs, and the colors just look really good together.
Yeah, so I had these seats made. They're Status Racing, and they're kind of their classic daily driver series, which is now discontinued. So I'm really glad I got these. But I sent them the red brown vinyl to match, and then had them change the stitching a little so that. They pretty much match the original seats with stitching and piping, and
I just can't get over how clean it looks. It's actually very comfortable to sit in, and just meticulous. All right, so you know, you originally had these little itty bitty pea shooters sticking out the back.
The original pea shooters were a lot smaller.
Right.
This has no mufflers. It comes straight out of the turbos.
I bet it sounds amazing. I bet it sounds really good. So, open this up. I need to see. You got twin turbos? I'm dying to see what's in there. I feel like if we walked into a museum and you wanted me to comment on an art piece, I'd have to stare at it for a little while.
Yeah, it's a little overwhelming. It's a lot going on.
I mean, even your firewall is stunning. What did you do all of those little swirly marks by
hand?
Yes,
I did. I think I spent about 20 hours.
You couldn't just have plain old sheet metal in there with scratches on it. You had to have...
Yeah, I made an indexing table and, you know, had the tool and each one.
It's beautiful. And you got all of these cooling fins throughout this whole system. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different. This is amazing.
Yeah, and since I couldn't fit an intercooler,
right,
I went with these finned pipes. Originally, I had one of these turbos with a 2.1 liter, and it was just instant boost. It's a variable vane turbo,
okay,
which there's not commonly used. It's an old turbo from the late 80s that came on a Chrysler Shelby CSX.
Okay. Very complicated, correct? I mean, did you have to figure out how to, first of all, fit everything in this compartment and then get them to play nice in the sandbox?
I kind of just got so wrapped up into it and making it work, I didn't really even think about, oh, is it going to have more lag or is this really worth it? And I just did it. So it took me a long time to fit everything and a lot of revisions and changes and upgrades and figuring out how to control the vanes, you know, manually control them because originally they were computer controlled, and you know how to keep the boost coming on quick.
It looks really good. I'm still just staring. My eyes are just darting from piece to piece to piece to piece. It's just really pretty.
Sometimes I'm surprised that it all fit and it worked.
All right, what do you got underneath here?
It's more like what don't I have? You got two turbos here.
Uh-huh.
I made little oil sumps for them going to a return scavenge pump. So it's water cooling.
Oh yeah, you have this methanol water injection. What are you doing there? What does that mean?
So that's called a chemical intercooler. So what it does, it injects water and methanol, or you know, one or the other, or both. You can mix it, and it injects it into the intake stream.
Okay.
So I also have it injecting here right before each turbo.
And that's chilling the air,
right
before it,
so
it gets to
it cools the air, which increases the efficiency of the turbos, and then it injects after the turbos.
Okay.
On the intake.
Before and after.
Wow. So, you know, the air gets heated from compression. So once the more boost, the more heat. And if that air gets hot enough, it'll start to knock.
Okay.
And, you know, so here's the inlet for the turbo. So the air filters are under here.
Uh-huh.
So I made an air box. But because it's a few inches off the ground, you get a lot more dirt and you get more heat. So it's the coldest air intake I can have. I've got, you know, pre-filter here and a pre-filter there, and then the air cleaners. So you got to kind of compensate. There's not a lot of room to do things on these, so you got to, you know, make it work. So I've also got, there's a fuel filter here.
Okay.
I put valves in it so I could change it without draining the whole system.
Right.
Chassis stiffeners all along each side here, and some bracing I added on both sides, front and rear. To stiffen up the pan, and then I added these jacking points.
Oh, smart.
There, and I made some cover plates here. This would be open.
Oh yeah, the air might get caught up in this area.
Yeah, I made an air dam here, because otherwise it would just go right up in here, and it would just.
Yeah, you so know, you could control directing the air right back.
Yeah, and then on the sides I made some plates here, so. It boxes all of that in and closes it off.
I mean, you've just been thinking about this car forever. And this is just this transformation process. You're constantly trying to fix or reinvent the wheel or come up and solve a problem. What else are you coming up with in your head?
Yeah, I've done exactly that. And as I learn more about other things and pick up ideas here and there, always think about how can I put that into the bug, and it's kind of, I call it like my masterpiece. It's like my art. So my wife always says, when's it going to be finished? And
never.
It's actually, I guess it won't, because there's always something to upgrade or improve. And
yeah, I think what's really cool is that your brain is just constantly, you've done a really good job.
Thanks.
I mean, your brain is just constantly going and thinking and doing, and this is just not a start and stop. This is literally a huge passion. Love it. I want to drive it.
All right.
Can I drive it?
Yeah.
Let's go do it.
All right.
Steering's a little stiffer because I had to add caster.
Looks good. What's your ideal RPMs for shifting? I don't know if it's specific or just by sound and feel.
Right around 6. You'll get some shift lights here.
Feel your turbo kicking in. Oh, right there. There was a little kick. Did you feel it?
We got two boost settings. Got 10 pounds and 14 pounds. So.
Well, let's go for 14.
Okay.
You got real nervous there for a second. Wow, I can feel that turbo. Can you see this?
Yeah.
Lumbar support. Hold on.
Yeah, it's because, you know, when you drive for hours to the racetrack or to a show or whatever.
Dude, this car is so rad. I'm like not sure if you want me to give it gas. Sounds really good doing that. Doesn't get old, does it? I like your bug.
So do I.
So before you met your wife, other girls come and go. Were they into the bug?
Yeah.
Is that like a thing?
Yeah, I had a girlfriend in college that had an old bug too.
Yeah.
And we just totally kind of hit it off. I started helping her fix it up, and you know, mine wasn't like this. It was
still
it was nothing like this, but it was cool. You know, we'd drive in her car, drive mine, and some good memories there.
Yeah, I don't know. I married my husband because he had big curly hair and an old Land Cruiser, so.
Oh, no. friends I haven't talked to in years and say, oh, you still got the bug? Yeah. And then they just can't believe it.
Right. Good sport. Thank you so much for letting me come and drive this thing. It's a beast. It's awesome and it handles fantastic. You did a really amazing job.
Thanks.
And I appreciate it. And you know what? Let me know if you guys would like to drive Mark's bug too in the comments. Not that he'll ever let you, but leave a comment, like, subscribe, and we'll see you next time. I don't know what I'm saying. I don't know until I say it. Like, you can just G out. Oh! You can just, holy crap. And you're really awesome for letting me come and hang out with you.
Sure.
Sure. I leave every time thinking I would like the car that I'm driving, but no, seriously, I want this one right now.
Well, I hope you enjoyed it, because that's all you're getting.
That's all I'm getting. Oh my gosh. The door is so close. Just talk to the GoPro. Talk to the GoPro. Leave us some engagement, comments. And I hate how that went. You guys know what to do. Okay, bye.